Huh?
Well,
it didn't take long for people to hand over their information.
And when we checked out, we left it sitting alongside the counter.
Identity theft is the fastest growing crime in the nation, according to criminal investigators.
You know what we're doing?
So we decided to find out how easy it was to collect someone's personal information.
Norma, you know.
We made a fake sign-up sheet to win a Toyota truck. We asked for their name, address, phone number, and social security. We even made a fake nonprofit organization up. I put on my mic.
Mic check, 1, 2, 3.
And set up in a high traffic area.
Now this is just so we make sure you're a U.S. citizen.
This is Bill. Bill gave me his name, phone number, address, and his date of birth. He didn't give me his social security number.
You can actually begin the process of assuming their identity with that.
I later told Bill it was all fake.
Oh, I'm surprised.
Yeah?
Yeah, I won't do that anymore either.
We notified the sheriff's department.
Colleen Hawker, however, wasn't so lucky.
I was looking through a paper, and there was this JobQuest evaluation, which is similar to a secret shopper.
She was asked to be a customer service evaluator. In the end, she was scammed out of almost $3,600.
Well, this one is a job scam. And you think you're doing a service, and you really aren't.
Not only did they get her monetarily, but they got her personally as well.
Some, however, say they can't be scammed.
Go ahead and pick one. Which one looks the most suspicious?
We showed several people some checks and asked them to pick out the fake one.
That one in the middle?
But the truth of the matter is, you can never tell which one's fake. They were all fake. This weekend, AEA Federal Credit Union is putting on a fraud fair to help protect people from scams like this and not become victims. This is Edgar Linares News, Channel 11.